In addition to the project preview window for viewing timeline edits, you can also open another preview window called the Media Library Preview window. The Media Library Preview window allows you to preview files or materials from the media library, and you can use it to perform single cuts or markers on media clips. To open the Media Library Preview window, click on View in the top menu bar, and then select Show Library Preview window. When this window is open, the functionality for viewing materials that were originally in the Project Preview window will be separated into the Media Library Preview window, allowing you to view and compare the content separately from the timeline. In this window, you can preview imported materials or built-in backgrounds, text templates, transition, overlay effects, and templates. Additionally, you can find some functions in this window that are similar to those in the Project Preview window, such as full screen, layout adjustments, snapshot capturing, and playback options. The Media Library Preview window also has an important feature that allows you to perform preliminary cuts on imported media clips before bringing them into the timeline. First, select the media material you want to edit, drag the slider for the start marker to the desired starting point, and then adjust the slider for the end marker to the end point. You can also use the shortcut keys I and O or the marking buttons below to set the markers. Once you have selected the clip, you can click the two buttons below to input the material into the timeline. When you click the left button, the clip will be inserted at the playback point on the selected track without overwriting the original material. If you click the right button, the clip will directly overwrite the clip at the current playback point. You can also use the Media Library Preview window to add markers to the clips. In the preview window, move the playback point to the desired marking location, then click the Add Clip Marker button, and the marker will appear at that position. You can double-click the marker to open the marker editing interface to change the name and comments. After inputting the clip into the timeline, the markers will also appear on the clip. One important thing to note is that when you directly input media from the media library into the timeline, the media will retain its full, uncut length. Only when you use the buttons in the Media Library Preview window to input the media will it be a trimmed clip. Additionally, any edits made in the Media Library Preview window will be retained after editing.